Hello, students. Today we are going to learn about electronegativity.
Sorry, I'm late.
Please sit down. Thank you. Electronegativity is how much an atom wants to gain an electron. Electronegativity increases up and right on the periodic table, but it does not include group 18. Nonmetals evidently want 8 valence electrons because it represents stability. Therefore, group 18 is excluded because they are already stable since they have 8 valence electrons. Metals' electronegativity is less than nonmetals' electronegativity. For example, oxygen has an electronegativity of 3.4, while sodium has an electronegativity of 0.9. Down a group, the electronegativity increasing atomic radius. Across a period, the electronegativity attraction is more because atomic radius decreases. This is because atomic radius affects the attraction between the protons and the electrons. Question?
So, how do elements actually gain valence electrons?
So, when a nonmetal and a metal bond, the metal transfers their valence electrons to the nonmetals, and then the nonmetals reach stability.
When are the bonds considered covalent?
Bonds are considered covalent when their electronegativity difference is lower than 1.7.
And I have one more. When are they, like, the bonds, if it's, like, polar or nonpolar, how are you supposed to tell the difference?
Okay, so no electronegative difference, or they share electrons equally. And bonds are considered polar when they share electrons unequally, and their electronegativity difference is big.
Okay, I got it. Thank you.
Action.
Good morning, class. Today we are learning about ionization energy. First, ionization energy is the amount of energy required to remove the most loosely bonded electron from an atom. So on the last orbital, elements with low ionization energy require less energy to remove an atom from their outermost shell. So, for example, metals, which are on this side of the periodic table, have less than 4 electrons in their last orbital, which is this number right here. And since they have less than 4 in their electrons, they want to lose an electron because they want to become stable since the number before is an 8. So the direction that the energy increases is up and right. So besides group 18, so nonmetals, which are on this side, right, have more than 5 electrons in their last orbital. So if they want to become stable, they want to keep their electrons.
Pause.
So does anyone have any questions?
Yes. Which direction do these trends go in again?
They go in from up and left. So the most right here is, this is fluorine.
Francium. No, that's not francium, that's fluorine.
Right, so that's the one that has the most because it has 2.7. It wants to hold their electrons so it can become 2.8.
So if it's like the bigger the atomic radius, then less energy is needed to require to remove a loosely electron?
Yes, because if you see right here, it has a 1 at the end, and it has, that's the most outer electron. So it will require less energy to take that 1 electron away.
But how come it requires more energy to remove an electron if their radius is smaller?
Because since you see here 2.7, they want to keep their electrons, so their electrons, they tend to be attracted to their nuclei, so they're attracted.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.